Okay, Britain. This was a slide which I missed last week, so I'm just including it here. The case of Britain was different. Britain was no more a nation state in the 18th century. Britain was one of the first country which became a nation state. Before 18th century, it was ethnic groups of English, Wales, Scots and Irish. Are you familiar with these countries? Now it is England, Wales, Scotland, and Ireland. All this together forms Great Britain now, okay? Now, before 18th century, it was just, ethnic groups. But among them, England was more powerful and wealthy. So, the more powerful nation start to expand their power and ambitions over all these regions, all these ethnic regions. So, constant growth of power and wealth helped England to be a dominant partner in this one. And also, in 1688, end of 17th century, monarchy was taken over by the parliament in England. A creation of a nation state was happened, and the parliament was there, and England was the center. So this also gave England an upper hand. And by the act of union, England formed a loose nation state with Scotland and Ireland was not, or Wales was there, Ireland was there as well, but Ireland was having its own trouble. They didn't want to join the Union. Scotland didn't have much voice there because they were suppressed and dominated by England. So by Act of Union, United Kingdom of Great Britain was formed. Later, there was Scotland and Ireland were, helpless partners in it. Every aspect of their life was dominated by the English majority. And Ireland and Scotland had got a distinctive culture, their own culture and the political institutions there. Everything was there, but it was all dominated by England after the Act of Union and formation of United Kingdom of Great Britain. And Ireland had a revolution which failed. It was under Wolfe with his organization United Irishmen. It failed, and England took over Ireland forcibly. Ireland was added to the Union by force after 1798. And 1801, a British nation was formed. Actually, Britain was formed in 1801. And it dominated every British system, British culture, British language. So, if you see about Britain, it is dominated by the British system, British way, or English way. England was a dominant partner, and all others were just helpless partners. Only resistance came from the Irish people, but Ireland was formed, means forcibly joined with the Union after the failed revolution of 1798. And in 1801, new British nation was formed. Then symbols of Britain, the flag, national anthem, and English language, and were actively promoted. And other nations were subordinate partners in the Union. Even now it is similar. England is the dominating one and all others are subordinate partners. So the case of Britain is entirely different. This is one of the first country which became a nation state, which was in 1801, way before French Revolution happened, the things started. But French Revolution happened in 1789, But 2 years after, Britain was a union, a nation state. Even the French Revolution happened, but nation state was formed later on, by the time Britain was a nation state. So the case of Britain is different. It is different from any other unification of national state. It was, you know, England dominated everybody else. England made a state of union, bring everybody under. Only one was struggling. It was Ireland. They tried a revolution, but it was failed. Then they were forcefully joined to the United Kingdom of Britain. And every aspect of the union was is dominated by the English culture and English ways. So this comes to conclude our topic, first chapter. Please ensure you are writing all the notes. As I say, whatever is on the slide is a note you have to prepare. And read your text. Make sure you are understanding more about it. You should be able to expand the points by yourself. If you have any doubt, please let me know. And yes, again, read your text. But also have some fun. Don't be behind the mobile all the time. Have a good time. See you. Bye-bye.